Good afternoon, everyone. We are so excited to see you all. Welcome to our annual Balinese gamelan concert. We're really excited to share a full program with you today. My name is Sonia Downing. I teach ethnomusicology here at Lawrence University. And more importantly for today, I'm a member of two of the groups that will be performing for you this afternoon. It is my great pleasure to introduce our director of gamelans at Lawrence University, E. Dewakatut Alit Adnyana. The next group is our family and children's gamelan, and I wanted to give a big thank you to the Lawrence Community Music School for supporting multiple ensembles of gamelan. We're so fortunate to have this incredible program here in Appleton, and thank you so much. I also wanted to mention that one of our college students, one of our Lawrence students, Gabe Raitley, is going to be joining this group playing suling, which is bamboo flute. And this group has a couple of pieces to share for you, so please enjoy. Thank you. The next group is our community gamelan, Gamelan Sekar Kemuda. This is also run through the Lawrence Community Music School. And we thought we would take just a few minutes to explain how Balinese gamelan music works, because there are a lot of things that are different that you might not be used to coming from a Western background. And so I wanted to explain a few of the aspects of this music before we get into the program. So one of the first things to know is that the main melody, what we call the core melody, is not at the top of the range, not in the high instruments like we might be used to listening for the flutes or violins in an orchestra or band, or the right hand in a piano, or the sopranos in a choir, but it's actually at the middle range. It's in the middle, played by our ugal player, and sometimes supported by the penyacha, some of these instruments over here. And so that's the melody that Balinese listeners would be paying a special attention to see if they like the melody of a particular particular piece. Now, there are multiple layers happening even higher than the melody and even lower than the melody, so I'll explain those a little bit, and then we will demonstrate how all those layers fit together. So at the lowest range, pitch-wise, is the gong cycle, and this is what provides the foundation and the large-scale rhythmic structure for most traditional gamelan pieces. The gong is struck every 4 or 8 or 256 beats, depending on the particular piece and the particular gong cycle. So we're going to demonstrate a 16-beat gong cycle. So once we get going, you can count 16 beats and pay attention for that the largest gong to be struck. Then there are smaller hanging gongs that will punctuate, in this case, the quarter points through that 16-beat repetition. Depending on the piece, those might be played in a different pattern, depending on the context. So that's one thing to watch for, and it's something that all gamelan musicians really pay attention to, because if you get lost in your own particular complicated part, you can always listen for the gong and then hear, oh, okay, there it is again, and then you know, okay, now we're back to the beginning of this particular repeated section. All right, the last aspect of the of gamelan music that I want to highlight is something that's really unique to Bali, which is that the parts, the elaborating parts, so the instruments that ornament and elaborate on the core melody, happen in a particular way that we refer to as interlocking parts. So this is played by the Gongsa family. Everybody else to my right, behind me here, the Gongsa instruments, as well as the rayong, which is the long row of gong chimes, the first row over here. They are playing with partners. So this is another thing that you can watch for. You can see that that musicians will be playing, sometimes alternating, with the person next to them. So what happens here is that the melody is ornamented in such a complex and often such a fast way that one person can't play all the notes. And so they separate them, they kind of unzipper them, and give some of those notes to half of the musicians to play. Those tend to be more on the beat. And then they give the other notes that tend to be more off the beat to their partner. And so when they're playing at the same time, the combined sound is that complex, ornamented melody. So we're going to layer this up for you. We're going to start with the gong cycle. We'll add in the core melody and then the supporting melody, which are the larger instruments over here that strike the same pitches as the core melody on the most important beats of the gong cycle. And then we will hear some elaborating melody, and then we'll demonstrate some of those interlocking parts. So here we go with the 16-beat gong cycle. Thank you. the core melody. And the supporting melody. And the elaborating melody. Half of the interlocking parts. Then you'll hear the other half of the interlocking parts. Then we'll put those together and you can listen and watch for the alternating mallets. We'll do the same thing with the rayong. So, musician one first. And then musician two. Together. Then we'll get the drum in and everyone all at the same time. Thank you. While they're setting up for the next piece, I want to highlight the fact that we have some students who have joined our community gamelan rehearsals, and we're so grateful for their presence and additional musicality. So again, Gabe Raitley has been joining us, as well as Mitchell von Eschen, who you'll hear on drum, Brock Daumler, and Dylan Donnelly. Next up is a special duet, Pak Dewa and Josh Patterson.
Thank you.
Just want to mention a couple things. This next piece that we're going to perform is a 20th century piece, and it breaks a lot of those rules that we just demonstrated for you a couple pieces ago. So one thing to watch for here is when the beat is steady and when it's not steady. There are passages called kebyar, which are like rhythmic explosions, just rhythmic bursts of lots of activity, and then a break, and then more activity, and then a break, and then eventually it will get into a steady gong cycle with a steady beat. The other thing I wanted to mention was that this is the last performance of our graduating high school senior, Eleonora Dane, who has been practicing and a member of our... Eleonora's been a member of our community gamelan for several years and has really grown up with us, and we're going to miss her so much. She's been a really strong off-the-beat player for quite a while, and we're going to miss her very much. And we wish her all the best in college next year. All right, thank you. Our last group is Gamelan Chahaya Asri. The name Chahaya Asri means Gamelan of beautiful light. So this is a play on Lawrence's motto, light, more light. This group has been rebuilding since the pandemic lockdown days, of course, when it was very difficult to have 15, 20, 25 people all in a relatively small room together. And this is actually now the biggest that the group has ever been, ever. So it's been a pretty awesome rebuilding time, actually. They've got some great pieces to share with you, and they're ready really fast. So here you go, Gamelan Chahaya Asri.